Let us now discuss about the power of an optical device. Here we are going to discuss about only thin lenses and the spherical mirrors. And about the same here we can write for a lens or a mirror, power gives an idea about its capacity to converge or diverge light rays falling on it. Let us see an example. Like here you can see this is a convex lens on which parallel light rays are incident onto it. Say we name it lens 1. And here you can see light rays are brought to focus after refraction from the lens, the two surfaces of lens at its focal point F. And so this is the focal length F1 of this lens. If we consider another lens, lens 2, then here we can see there is also a convex lens, but in the situation when parallel light is incident onto it, these are converged at a point which is quite closer to the lens, or we can say it is having lesser focal length. Then if I ask in both of the lenses which one is more converging for light rays, then certainly we say it is second lens or lens 2. Because in this situation bending of light rays is more and the focal length is less. So here we'll simply say lens 2 is having more power to converge light rays compared to lens 1. Or we can say here lens 2 is more powerful than lens 1. Similarly, we can continue our discussion on concave lenses on the next sheet. Let's continue our discussion on concave lenses. Here you can see this is a concave lens on which parallel light rays are falling onto it and it is diverging light rays after refraction from the two surfaces. Now say if this is considered as lens 1 and say the focal length of the lens is F1, that is the point where the light rays appear to be originating and diverging after refraction. And if we consider this lens, which is here named as lens 2, which is also a concave lens on which parallel rays are incident. And here you can see this diverging relatively more the light rays after refraction. And you can see due to more divergence in light rays are appear to be coming from the focal point, which is more closer to the lens, or say its focal length F2 here is less than F1. So again here we can see that the power of lens 2 is more in terms of diverging light rays. So here again we can say lens 2 is more powerful than lens 1. The similar phenomena we can define for spherical mirrors also. Here you can see there is a concave mirror M1. On which say parallel rays are incident after reflection, these rays are converged to a point at the focus of the lens, which is at a distance F1. And say if this M2, which is again a concave lens, where light rays are converging to a point F2, which is relatively far away from the mirror, and in this situation the focal length F2 is more than F1. Then if we talk in terms of a converging behavior of light rays after reflection, you can see lens 1 is converging light rays more compared to mirror 2. So in this situation we can say mirror 2 is less powerful than mirror 1 in terms of converging light rays. So when we talk about numerical value of power of a lens or a mirror can be directly given as inverse of the focal length of the lens. as we have seen, a focal length is less, the mirror or lens is said to be more powerful. So here we can directly define the power of a lens or a mirror. This P can be written as reciprocal of focal length. And if focal length is measured in meters, then the unit is given as a diopter. Or it is abbreviated or symbolically represented by the symbol D. But you must be careful, diopter will be used as a unit for measurement of power only when F is measured in meter. So you must be careful for analyzing the power of a lens. When I require, you can directly take as a reciprocal of the focal length of the mirror or lens.